KPCC and my all senior colleagues in AICC, I would like to say sorry to all of you for the delay which happened in the morning. And primarily that delay was due to the last day of nomination. I hope you understood everything and we will have a better relationship in the days to come. Friends, every day, I don't know whether Kannadigas are fed up, whenever you pick up the newspaper in the morning, you will find a new scam. And today I am highlighting a scam because you might have heard in Karnataka we had Anda scam, COVID scam, tender scam, Raghavendra scam, bank loan scam, the Bangalore Development Authority scam, cooperative banks scam. Today, there is a very unique scam, and the scam in two words will be take land, give membership. And that is what happened in the Bangalore Golf Club. In the Bangalore Golf Club, the lease period got expired in 2021. The government was not in a mood to extend the lease period. Just few weeks before the model code of conduct came in place, the lease was extended for 30 more years. But there is a quid pro quo, because that is the habit of this ...40% commission Sarkara. What is that quid pro quo? Give us the land, take the membership. You will be surprised, and this is as per the sources, that 12 BJP MLAs and BJP executives or office bearers got out of turn memberships. Even the golfers like Aditi Ashok Munyappa is not getting membership. Golfer like S. Chikrangappa is not getting membership. But our BJP members and BJP MLAs are getting membership. And for that membership, what they gave? They gave the land for 30 more years. So everywhere you will find the current 40% commission Sarkar. I thought membership will be fair. But even after Anda, now membership. Earlier you had eaten Andas, now you are eating membership of the golfers or the genuine people who are in the queue for last 15 years, 20 years. Now you are taking their right to become member of the prestigious Bangalore Golf Club. And there we want to ask today a very specific questions. The number one, who all are politicians and bureaucrats? We want the list. Who got the membership because of this U-turn by 40% commission Sarkara? The entire Bangalore city people, the golfers community, the sporting community, the community which love games, is eager to know who all are bureaucrats and politicians who got this out-of-turn membership. Because enough is enough. You did a scams in tender, you did a scams in bank loans, you did a scam in COVID, you did a scam in procurement of the medical equipment, you did a scam in the cooperative banks, you did a scam in Bangalore Development Authority, and now even membership is also a scam. Shame on you, 40% commission Sarkara chief. Shame on you. On the moral grounds, I think before 23rd you will take your name back. On the moral grounds, you are not eligible to contest the assembly election. Whatever scams of the world are there, this 40% commission Sarkar did those scams. This was our agenda number one. Friends, we had another agenda, because again, the pride of the people of Karnataka was attacked by none other than the chief of Bharatiya Janata Party, Shri J.P. Nadda. And I will show you one small video of 10 seconds and then I will ask few questions to him. I'm playing this video in front of all of you. See what he is asking. He is telling blessings of Modi ji is required for Karnatikas. We had learned from our forefathers that blessings of God was required. Blessings of parents is required. Blessings of elders are required. But here he is telling, no, you require blessings of Modi ji. Modi ji, what kind of blessing is that? Is this a blessing to commit 40% fraud? Is this a blessing to commit, Modi ji, the fraud in the COVID? Or this is a blessing for land grab? Or this is a blessing for PSI scam? Or this is a blessing for sex for job scam? Or this is a blessing for food kit scam? Or is this a blessing for Bitcoin scam? Or this is a blessing for Vijender scam? What kind of blessings is this? Nadda ji, from this podium I want to say, Karnataka doesn't require 40% commission Sarkara as a blessing. This is not blessing, that is a shrap. We don't require any shrap. We require blessings of Karnataka. On one side, Bharatiya Janata Party is saying that Karnataka will be blessed by Modi ji. On the other side, Congress Party is saying that Government of Karnataka will be blessed by the people of Karnataka. We require blessings of Karnatikas. We don't require blessings of Modi ji. We don't require, don't again and again every day, morning to evening, you are hitting the pride of Karnataka. You are hitting the pride of Karnatikas. Whether it is CRPF exams in Hindi and English, or it is Nandini, or it is the 865 villages, the budget was made by the Maharashtra government. Whenever the pride of Karnataka is under attack, you will find either 40% commission Sarkara is mum, silent. 26 BJP MPs, the people of Karnataka gave BJP 26 Lok Sabha MPs. None of them is able to say that we don't require blessings of Modi ji, we require blessings of Bhagwan. We require blessings of our parents. We require blessings of our elders. And Congress Party is proud to say that we are going to form the government on 13th of May with the blessings of the people of Karnataka, not with the blessings of someone else. And if the blessings means 40% commission, Bhagwan humko bachaye, we don't require such blessings. If the blessings means 40%, this is not blessing, this is a shrap. And we don't want any shrap from Modi ji. So, this is my item number two. I am open for questions if you have any on this subject or any other subject. I will try to answer all of them. I don't know. The prominent newspapers are publishing that as a front page news. I want to know who all are them. Who all are bureaucrats? Who got the membership in the Bangalore Golf Club? Who all are BJP office bearers and BJP MLAs? Who got membership out of turn? People in Bangalore are waiting for 20 years, 30 years. Golfers like, as I named few golfers, those golfers like Aditi Ashok Munyappa, S. Chikrangappa is not able to get membership. But I don't know. Because BJP might be playing better golf than these professional golfers. who was denied the membership of Bangalore Golf Club. So we want that their list should be out, that who all got the benefit of this U-turn. What is a U-turn? Earlier we were not renewing the lease license. You now had renewed that for 30 more years. Why? Why you had changed the mind? And who all are beneficiaries? And why those people got out of turn membership? Why professional golfers are not getting membership? We want to know. Any other question? Madam Shobha ji, I thought you will make a comment when the Nandini brand of KMF was under attack. I thought you will open your mouth when the CRPF 1.3 lakh constable exams were held in only in Hindi and English. I thought that you will say something when Maharashtra government was making a health insurance budget for 865 villages of Karnataka. But what you said, Shobha ji, I will share two photographs with all of you. Please read this. In 2008, when there was a no confidence motion against the UPA, the same person, Atik, was not voting in favor of UPA. His party was voting in favor of UPA, but Atik was favoring BJP. Shobha ji, ye rishta kya kehlata hai? What is this relationship? Why Atik is your B team? Because he had defied his party's whip in 2008 when BJP came out with a no confidence motion against the UPA. One, Atik was favoring BJP. Then also, Shobha ji, I will show you one photo and you have to answer this photograph, Shobha ji, before going out from Bangalore or Karnataka. Whose photo is with Atik? He is the Nand Gopal Gupta Urf Nandi. Who is he? He is the current cabinet minister of BJP Uttar Pradesh. He holds portfolio of industrial development, export promotion, NRI, that is his ministry. And what is this relationship, Shobha ji? Ye kya baat ho rahi hai? Ye has kyo rahe? See the laugh. Why the BJP minister, who is the current BJP minister, why he is laughing with Atik? What is your relationship, Shobha ji? I know you can't open your mouth whenever there is a question on the pride of Kannadigas. But you raised a question, I am responding to you. Ye kya hai? What is this? Why Atik is having a photograph with the current UP cabinet minister? What is their relationship? The BJP has to answer this. Any other question? We will be having Shri Pilot during our campaign. The question of a star campaigner, I am asking a counter question to BJP. You might have heard about bottle openers, but there is an emergency gate opener in our country. Why that emergency gate opener's name is not in the BJP's star campaigner's list? Are they going to throw the emergency gate opener? And you understand, Bangalore people understand who is emergency gate opener. I am talking about the Member of Parliament of BJP, Mr. Tejaswi Surya. who is also the National Youth President of BJP, Yuva Morcha. Why BJP's emergency gate opener's name is not there in the campaign, star campaigners list of BJP? I am asking another question. You took after a lot of pride. Your ministers were taking chappals in the hands. Why Jyotiraditya Scindia's name is not there in the star campaigners list? Why Jatin Prasad, who was who's who for you, why his name is not there in your star campaigners list? Why RPN Singh's name is not there in star campaigners list? Why Ajaz Saab's name is not there in your star campaigners list? Answer these things. But I can tell you proudly that Sachin Pilot ji is going to campaign for us. My name is not there in star campaigner. His name is not there. Alka's name is not there. Are we not campaigning? Our primary motivation right now is to take the BJP 40% commission Sarkara out of this state. And before you ask questions to us, please ask the emergency gate opener that why BJP is he going to be the next Ishwarappa ji? Then he will say, I don't want to contest election. Thank you very much. Is he going to do that thing? I think so. Because BJP is giving indications to him. Any other question? ऐसा कुछ नहीं है. There is nothing like that. This is a party's strategy. And there is nothing like that because the people who had seen the procession of nomination filing of D.K. Shivkumar ji, on that day itself, BJP, they had some internal survey that this seat is gone for more than 1 lakh votes. BJP is going to lose that seat. So there is nothing like that. There is a part of our long-term strategy. No. We had certain strategies. We will share with you as whenever the proper time will come. But I can tell you one thing, and this is an internal survey, that Shiv Kumar ji, who is the Karnataka Pradesh Congress Committee president, he is going to win this election by more than 1 lakh votes. And if you can't believe this, I will share his nomination filing procession. In crane, there is a garland which was lifted by crane. That is the popularity of the KPCC president. Nothing like that, nothing more than. मैं आपको बोल रहा हूं ना, that is what I am trying to say, that as and when we will feel appropriate, we will share. But this is more at the strategic issue. Thank you. No, nothing like that. No, nothing like that. Nothing like that. And we had a full faith on the democratic process. We had a full faith on the election commission. And we had full faith on the autonomy of these institutes. I'm telling you, Shiv Kumar ji is going to win this election by more than 1 lakh votes. Thank you.